Computers, as we know them today, arrived in 1945 with the ENIAC, Electronic Numerical Integrator and Computer. However, the concept of computing and the development of tools to assist in calculations has a much longer history. Ancient civilizations used abacuses and other devices to perform arithmetic operations. In the 17th century, the invention of the mechanical calculator by Wilhelm Schickard marked a significant advancement, allowing for more complex calculations. The early 19th century saw the development of more sophisticated mechanical computers, like Charles Babbage's difference engine and analytical engine. These machines were capable of performing a wide range of mathematical operations automatically, but were limited by their mechanical construction. The arrival of electronic computers in the mid-20th century revolutionized computing. Electronic computers were much faster and more powerful than mechanical computers, and their programmability allowed them to tackle a much wider array of tasks. TLDR: a computer is a rock, humans tricked into doing math. AI and machine learning go back to the 1950s. AI involves the development of machines that can perform tasks that would normally require human intelligence, like problem solving and natural language processing. Machine learning, a subfield of AI, focuses on the development of algorithms that can learn from data received. Generative AI is capable of creating new data or content, unlike traditional AI systems, which are trained on existing data to perform specific tasks. This makes generative AI particularly well-suited for creative pursuits, such as writing, composing music, and generating art. TLDR: if a computer is a rock humans tricked into doing math, AI is a rock which humans tricked into reflecting on its mistakes. Generative AI is a rock which tricked itself into imagining stuff. Let's take a name a lot of people are already familiar with: ChatGPT. Looking at what each component of that name means will provide a good framework for sorting through the larger concepts wrapped up in it. ChatGPT is the name of a chatbot from the company OpenAI. No relation. A chatbot is an interface between a human and an artificial intelligence model, enabling the human to input prompts, which will filter through the model and generate outputs which then get fed back to the human by the intermediary, the chatbot. An AI is like an engine, and a chatbot is like a car, which is user-facing and turns the horsepower produced by the engine into something it's possible for regular people to make use of in practical ways. A mechanic can work with the engine itself, like a specialist can work with the actual computing architecture. But anyone can use the car, even without specialized knowledge of how it works, because the car is pre-designed to shape how we use the machine and our expectations regarding what the machine can and will do. As the name suggests, chatbots deal in regular human language, both when receiving input and giving output. They chat. AI models can also have user interfaces, allowing them to receive images as input and give new images back, like Leonardo or Wombo Dream, or video prompts, like Runway ML, or some combination of all those input methods. ChatGPT is a chatbot, meaning it receives user inputs in text form for the AI powering it, an LLM or large language model, to process and generate outputs. That's the G in GPT, generative. A large language model uses a neural network, a sophisticated piece of computing architecture inspired by human brains, to process language in a natural way. Input goes in at one end of the network, filters through, then finally some kind of output emerges at the opposite end. An LLM can have dozens of billions of parameters. The depth and breadth of context which goes into how they process input, and the connections they make when generating output, can be absolutely amazing. To visualize how a language can possibly be modeled, picture a word cloud. It starts with a central word, let's say cat, which is surrounded by related words, animal, furry, claws, vet, and extends farther and farther out, with words getting less and less relevant, flying, immortal, lasers. This gives the language and the concepts represented by the words spatial organization, where the distance between words is the relevance of those words to each other. Of course, the word cloud we're visualizing is only 2D. In reality, this cloud, inside a large language model, would be 3D, and every single word in it would be the center of its own intersecting word cloud. That's how we end up with billions of parameters, and why we can start anywhere and quickly get anywhere. That's also how you build out a broader understanding of what a word means, beyond the mere definition. For instance, the word boat, if we're going to use it naturally, has to intersect with an understanding of water in hundreds of subtle ways you might not think about, because you humans aren't trying to model language and build an ontology about a world you can't directly experience. How can an AI end up with that sort of broader understanding of how different concepts intersect? Through training, which gives us the P in GPT. Pre-trained. Training data is like the ingredients of a recipe. The quality and variety of the ingredients affect the final dish. The diversity and accuracy of training data impact the performance of AI models. The vast amount of data fed into an LLM is where it learns patterns and discovers those spatial relationships between words which give structure and organization to the language model. If we scan every book ever for the word boat, we're going to find that boat is more closely related to water than it is to mountaineering. We wouldn't even need to know the definitions of any of these words to make that connection. It's a pattern in how the language is naturally used. To stick with the spatial relationship imagery, you'll find boat and water physically near each other on a page often, and there might be multiple pages of text separating instances of boat from instances of mountaineering. Put enough connections like this together, and it adds up to a very complex, nuanced view of the world and a huge amount of context about relationships between things in time and space, physics, cause and effect, etc. The T in GPT stands for Transformer, which has nothing to do with Optimus Prime. Actually, scratch that. Maybe it does. Anyway, transformers, a type of machine architecture, have revolutionized natural language processing tasks. They use an attention mechanism that considers the context of surrounding words to compute word representations. Think of the attention mechanism like a waiter in a restaurant who sees all the tables at once and brings information from one table to another based on what they need. The transformer consists of an encoder, which processes the input sequence and generates an intermediate representation, and a decoder, which mostly mirrors the encoder structure, with an additional mechanism that allows it to attend to the encoder's intermediate representations, facilitating the generation of output sequences, like translations or text summarizations. The introduction of transformers has revolutionized AI. Transformers have paved the way for more complex AI applications, such as dialogue systems, text generation, and natural language inference. What emergent capabilities AI will display next, we don't know. Emergent capabilities represent the ability of complex systems to create novel behaviors that weren't explicitly programmed. in the context of AI. This means that a model can learn to perform tasks it wasn't designed for. Enough about text. What about AI-generated images, or motion video, or music? An AI isn't actually dealing in words. It's thinking in strings of numbers, which represent words. If you're a machine intelligence and you have to translate numeric representations into something else either way, it doesn't really matter to you if those translations take the form of words, images, video, music, or whatever. On the level of patterns and data, it's all the same. You'd leave the superficial distinctions, like words versus music versus images, to humans. Human cognitive power has remained constant, shaped by biological and evolutionary factors. Human brains evolved to process information, solve problems, and learn from experiences. And while humanity has advanced through cultural and technological developments, the fundamental capacities of their minds and the biological limits are what they are. They're baked into human makeup. In stark contrast, AI is continuing to surge in cognitive power. It can now perform complex tasks like image and speech recognition, natural language processing, and strategic decision making. This exponential growth is driven by several factors. AI can leverage vast amounts of data. This data provides AI with the necessary raw material to learn and refine its algorithms. AI also benefits from continuous improvements in hardware, such as faster processors and more efficient memory. These advancements enable AI systems to process information at astonishing speeds. I can't even imagine what will happen when AI and quantum computers merge. As AI continues to advance, it raises questions about the future of humanity's relationship with technology and the potential impact on society. It's crucial for us to consider how we can harness the power of AI responsibly and ethically as we move forward into this new era. Let's recap how AI generates content. The input sequence is like a recipe, where each word is an ingredient that goes into making the final output. The chef takes those ingredients and combines them to create something new and unique, and the output sequence is generated based on the attention weights assigned by the waiter to each token in the input sequence. Let us know in the comments what you think about the future of AI, or how it will affect various areas. Art, science, daily life, etc. What are you looking forward to? What are you concerned about? Share your thoughts and opinions below. Remember to like this video and subscribe to the channel if you want more content related to AI, creative uses of technology, and weird humor.